They speak about the luck of the Irish. But you, Jamie Fraser, you're the lucky man.
What do you want, Torrox?
To sail to the colonies. Boston, I fancy.
Then go. Scotland won't miss you.
I'm gonna need money for my venture.
You'll have plenty in your pockets after the raid, on the rent party.
That's a start, but not much of one. Not after I divvy the pot with the others. My thinking was, maybe you'd be willing to help a fella. Same way as I'm helping you by keeping my mouth shut.
For a price, I'm sure.
You're a canny lad. But you put up some money now, and I swear, you'll not see my face again.
Governor. Thought you'd cut a striking figure in this.
Sir?
Well, you're one of my best officers. Not gonna have you mistaken for an insurgent.
I appreciate the gesture, Your Excellency, but I don't think it proper for me to wear such a garment.
Much too humble, Colonel. I know that you, more than most, will take this battlefield are deserving of the privilege, so... please. Do me the honor. Striking figure indeed.
What's that you're giving him?
It'll help him heal.
Morton.
I hope you didn't waste any good medicine on that coward. He was running away like a scared rabbit when he was felled.
I wasn't running away. You saw what happened.
Powder burns were on his back. So whoever shot him at close range.
No woman speaks to me like that.
What have you done? No.
Naturellement, Maître Raymond, cela doit strictement rester entre vous et moi.
Bien entendu, monsieur.
Ça va de soi. Ah, Madonna! What a pleasure to see you again. Je crois que vous connaissez Monsieur le Comte.
Oui. Nous avons déjà fait connaissance.
Oui, en effet.
Great. From my commander. He requests your courtesy in giving temporary shelter to Mrs. Beecham, an English gentlewoman we rescued last night.
Oh. My dear Mrs. Beecham, I should be delighted to offer you the hospitality of my humble home.
I thank you, Your Grace. My commander will be most obliged. Good day, Mom.
I need a drink. Something to eat. And so do you, from your appearance. Rescued, did it say? Rescued from what? Rabid bears?
Highlanders.
Much the same thing.
You mentioned a drink.
Castle Lear, Lady Mackenzie.
She was not Mrs. Fraser when we first became acquainted. She was Mistress Beecham then.
Go on.
I came to her for a potion. to open Jamie Fraser's heart to my own. I'm sorry, it's painful to speak about. I was the one, you see, who Jamie was meant to marry. But she took the potion herself.
Did you concoct such a potion?
It wasn't an actual potion. I was just trying to help her.
I say we kill her.
Leave her for the beasts. You know Fraser's got his hands full for a while.
Still. Well, that was you.
Well, aren't you the clever one? Dr. Rawlins. You never thought anyone would find out about your little newspaper column, did you? Well, now you're going to repent for your sin.
I was just trying to help.
Spreading dangerous ideas, what you mean? Telling women how to deceive their husbands, how to deny them their God-given rights. Telling my wife to avoid my bed. And I'm going to take you to Brownsville. And you're going to confess to the women folk there. And they're going to see you for the charlatan that you are.
I only spare you because Claire is fond of you.
Galus, don't! Galus!
Galus, life for a life, sweet Claire. I saved you from the pyre after the witch trial. You owe me a life. He's just a boy. He's just fodder for my passage. It's your daughter's life you owe me. Galus, I have to clear. For the greater good.
It was then I realized that the pool was the portal.
We are the chosen, you and I. We have a responsibility to change history. I gave up my child for the cause. You must do the same. This is God's will.
Can you hear it? You see, Connor.
What are you doing here?
I was walking down the thoroughfare in Wilmings. And I saw you from afar. I thought to myself, doesn't she look familiar? You see, I never forget a face. Neither yours nor your lovely daughter's. She seems to have inherited your beauty. How's my son? Does he resemble his handsome father?
You don't have a son!
You're misinformed. Your daughter told me as much, to my face.
I think I found...
Free, run!
No.
Go! Go!
I am not leaving you. Let her go!
Shoot him! Let her go!
Put that down, or I'll cut her throat on the count of three. One. Two.
Wait! Wait!
I let your mother go. As long as you come along with me. It's my son and you I'm wanting.
Right, wake up. Your presence.
Ah!
Are you watching? Stop! Make me a better offer. Of me. Let her go in safety and you can have me. I won't struggle. You can do what you wish.
Leave me now.
You have my word.
So, it becomes a matter of trust. Your word for mine.